Good day. My name is Steve. I'm a factory-trained Tuttenhauer service technician, and today I'm going to demonstrate cleaning and maintenance on the Tuttenhauer EZ10 automatic autoclave. The most important part of cleaning is the use of chamber bright. Chamber bright is recommended by Tuttenhauer Corporation. It will clean the reservoir, the pipes, and valves within the unit. It's very important to keep any residue off the interior pipes and chamber of the unit. This will ensure a working unit many years into the future. Now that the chamber's clean, we can wipe down our tray rack and reinsert. Press the sides in, reach in and grab the two, pull together to align tray. Reinstall the rest of your trays, and your cleaning procedure is complete. It's recommended that weekly that the gasket sealing the chamber be wiped. This is best done at cleaning. Take a damp rag or sponge and clean off the edge of the gasket as well as the edge of the chamber. This is the first step if you have a chamber leak, which would be evident by a little water gathering at the bottom of the door. Approximately yearly, or at signs of wear, it's time to change your door gasket. Easiest way to do it is to pull out the old gasket. You'll notice that the gasket has a trapezoidal shape. This diameter, this dimension, and this dimension are slightly different. The larger side goes to the outside. When replacing the gasket, your new gasket should be placed at the and pressed in at the 12 o'clock position. Let it hang naturally, even out both sides, and press in at the 6 o'clock position. Then the 3 o'clock, then the 9 o'clock. Keep going around opposing sides until the gasket is firmly seated all the way around. Run your thumb all the way around and evenly press in the gasket. Final step, close the door and tighten your gasket, which will help to seat it. After it's been closed, it will be even, and you'll be ready for your next batch of processing. Cleaning the air jet valve is one of the most important maintenance functions of the autoclave. It is a small device, and yet it controls how much steam is in the chamber. Without it, you will fail spore test. Make sure you do this procedure weekly. Interior, take the top off, and interior of the reservoir, you'll see a paperclip style wire in a valve. Move this in and out repeatedly while the unit is under pressure. This is great to do during a cleaning cycle when you have at least 25 pounds of pressure. You can do it without pressure, but this guarantees that any debris is blown out.
The book might say do it 10 times. I do it a little bit more. And that will ensure that you release any air trapped inside the chamber. We need 100% steam. And during the cleaning cycle, when the pressure in the unit reaches 30 psi or greater, now is a good time to clean the safety valve. This will release hot steam. Be very careful performing this procedure. Remove the safety cover. You can use the end of a screwdriver or a long implement if you have to grab the safety ring and pull outwards for at least 2 seconds. This blows debris out of the safety valve, ensures that this important device is functioning, and keeps your autoclave performing to peak performance for years to come.
In the rear of the unit is a strainer valve. This should be cleaned about once a month. We've turned the unit around to make it easy to see. With the machine cold, because this unit will become very hot after the unit operates, you'll see these units: a strainer, a gasket, and the top. Be careful of the gasket, they do fall out. Strainer can be rinsed under running water, cleaned of any debris, reinstalled back in the lid, screwed back into the unit, good finger tight. A pair of pliers can be used to open and close this valve. Periodically, it's advised to oil the door hinge and handle. A few drops of oil in this on the door hinge, on the thread, and especially between these two plates right here. Oil, spin in, spin out, and you're through. These plates right here is essential to oil. One plate should spin. Approximately yearly, the air filter on the EZ10 needs to be replaced. This is a HEPA filter and replaced by turning to release, pulling the hose off the old unit, disconnecting the old unit from the top, reinserting the new unit, pressing the hose in carefully, lining up tabs, and turning to close. You've just replaced your HEPA filter.